Pakistan. The country is mired in political turmoil. First, it was Gujranwala and now Karachi. A second massive show of strength against Prime Minister Imran Khan was staged in Karachi today. Senior opposition leaders and thousands of protesters took to the streets to demonstrate against the Imran Khan government and the military's role in the establishment. In early afternoon on Sunday, the Pakistani Muslim League Nawaz's Vice President Maryam Nawaz arrived in Karachi. Nawaz was greeted by a large number of party workers at the airport itself. Hundreds of people rallied along with her car, throwing rose petals and shouting slogans. Now, earlier this week, top opposition leaders put up a massive show of power at Gujranwala, taking Imran Khan's so-called puppet government heads on. The opposition rally led to major controversy in the de facto military state. Former Prime Minister Nawaz Sharif accused Pakistan's Army Chief General Qamar Javed Bajwa of toppling his government. He also claimed that the military leadership installed their yes man in his position. A series of rebuttals followed this rally. A disgruntled Prime Minister Imran Khan lashed out at Sharif for maligning the image of military's leadership. He threatened that Nawaz Sharif will now be kept in a common jail. Maryam Nawaz, the daughter of the erstwhile head of state, came out in his support, tearing apart the Prime Minister's comments. Maryam said that this is a game of political stalwarts and that he, meaning Imran Khan, should stay out of it. Listen in to what Nawaz said.
एक हारे हुए शख्स की तकरीर थी वो, जिसको बहुत गुस्सा था, लेकिन मियां साहब ने तो उनको एड्रेस किया ही नहीं. मियां साहब ने कहा था कि ये आपका खेल है, आप इसमें से बाहर रहे.
अच्छा मैडम, क्या कि
ये बड़ों की लड़ाई में छोटों का कोई काम नहीं. पहले भी आम जेलों में ट्रीट किया गया था. अगर कोई ये समझता है कि जेल में कोई सहूलियात थी तो वो गलत समझता है. ये जो धमकियां है ना, ये किसी और को देना.
और गिरफ्तारियों से खौफ ज्यादा तो नहीं?
दो दफा गिरफ्तार होके चार चार पाँच पाँच छह छह महीने जेल काट आए. आप गिरफ्तारी से किसका खौफ? जो खौफ था वो भी खत्म हो गया.
More details, let's quickly go across to our guest Mateen Heather, who's joining us live on the broadcast tonight. He's a senior journalist and he's joining us live from Islamabad. Thank you so much, Mateen, for joining us on this broadcast. Now, Pakistan's foreign minister says that the Pakistan Democratic Movement is a temporary alliance because the movement lacks one leader or even one ideology. But what do you make of the movement and its massive show of strength that's very much visible on the roads?
Well, definitely, one part of your question, I'll agree that there is definitely a state power. And as far as the claim by Foreign Minister Shah Mahmood Qureshi, who made this statement in Multan earlier this afternoon, this is not a temporary alliance. Of course, Khan has completed 2 years and he is now into the third year. So the remaining 3 years, he is going to face tough pressure by Pakistan Democratic Movement. But surprisingly, whatever was the tone and tenor of former Prime Minister Nawaz Sharif, who very harshly spoke against military's leadership, today the statements carried by Pakistani media, that means that the statement made by Bilawal Bhutto Zardari yesterday, he disassociated himself whatever was said by Nawaz Sharif. That means naming of army generals and inter-services intelligence top leadership and army chief Qamar Javed Bajwa's name number of time was named by Mr. Nawaz Sharif. Bilawal Bhutto Zardari expressed displeasure over this and he said they didn't want to name army generals into it. So now the situation ahead is definitely quite critical for PDM. As now government is seriously considering banning this particular Pakistan Democratic Movement if anti-state statements or activities continue to take place. Although there is no such decision, but there is very strong move that if they will continue to be on the path of anti-state narrative, so there could be tough and harsh actions by the state in return.
And since you mentioned these tough and harsh actions, I'm very curious to ask you, Pakistan's opposition leaders earlier had announced that they would use all political and democratic options to seek the removal of Imran Khan and end the military's role. What are the options and how viable are they if they were even to resort to a no-confidence motion or even mass resignations from the parliament?
Yes, well, this is what the right constitutional and legal option is, to move a vote of no confidence motion. That is very much parliamentary. That is very much legal. That is within the framework of parliamentary democracy. If joint opposition thinks so, that they have they are in a number to move no confidence motion, of course they can move it. That is absolutely a legal and constitutional way to remove Khan's government. But other than that, struggling on the roads and streets, that is their democratic right also. That is also freedom of expression. And they have every right to definitely bring people on the roads, on the public meeting grounds. And that is, they are justified as well as far as strike hike is concerned, because common people in Pakistan, they are quite upset over price hike, over economic miseries, economic issues. But talking about national security, talking about custodians of national security, speaking dirty language against national security institution, that means Pakistan Army and inter-services intelligence, that is Pakistan's internal security matter. What concern Mr. Nawaz Sharif has to do with the country's military establishment, that by speaking against them, Mr. Nawaz Sharif has put himself into a very deep trap, into the trouble, and after that, and now definitely in Karachi's public meeting, he's not going to speak. And he was already banned in Gujranwala's meeting, which was not broadcast by TV channels in Pakistan. So I would say that he's Altaf Hussain 2 now. Whatever the language, tone, tenor, and narrative of Altaf Hussain was MQM's former chief. So Nawaz Sharif is adopting the role and replica of Altaf Hussain. That means the politics.
Right, Mateen, fair enough when it comes to Nawaz Sharif. But let's also talk about Imran Khan. He made the anti-corruption campaign the centerpiece of his rule. What do you make of the drive that has clearly been one-sided, mainly targeting Khan's political opponents while leaving members of his own governing party or their allies largely untouched?
Very good. So your question is $1 million valid, right? So on the basis of definitely the slogan of corruption, he won the elections, he came into power. And yesterday, I will definitely draw your attention to his speech that he made at Convention Center in Islamabad, that he will take the corruption cases to the logical end. So there are big question marks on Mr. Khan's drive against corruption, that why not a single corruption cases has reached to the conclusion, right? Although yesterday he made it very clear that he will ask National Accountability Bureau to speed up the pending cases. So this is big question mark, or not only over Khan, but his team as well, that why the cases of corruption against definitely either PMNL, Pakistan Muslim League leaders, or Pakistan People's Party leaders, or likewise, there are so many other business tycoons, many other people. So as far as the campaign against corruption is concerned, it's with a question mark that there is no speedy recovery of looted money into the kitty. Two big issues before Khan. One, he has to control price hike. And second, he has to bring back the looted money back to the government kitty. By doing this, so he will restore his confidence. Otherwise, opposition will continue to mount
Mateen. I'm afraid we'll have to leave it at that, and we'll have to wait and watch to see how the Pakistan Democratic Movement actually pans out, and if something concrete emerges out of this. As you said, there are the next 3 years, which will, of course, pose stiff competition to Imran Khan. On that note.